us for our midweek Bible study today. And my name is Dan Forwood, and I'm going to attempt to fill the shoes of Pastor Cliff Curry tonight. And like I said, I will attempt to do that. Before we do get into the message, into opening our scripture, we have a few prayer concerns. We ask you to pray for the Listerman family and the loss of their baby daughter, Summer. We also ask you to pray for the Huddleston family and the loss of her father, Dennis Lucas. Pray for Paula Lilly's friend, Lisa Allen. She's still struggling with the effects of COVID. Aaron Lilly's uncle was released from rehab facility for treatment from a broken hip. His recovery is still not going well, so please pray for his improvement. Also pray for those who have recently lost loved ones as they grieve during this holiday season. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we thank you for the blessings you give us each and every day, most of all for our salvation. Lord, we thank you for our homes and our families, and Lord, this being a week that we celebrate the national holiday of Thanksgiving, we do want to give you thanks. And as Christians, we want to give you thanks each and every day. But during this time, we may have the opportunity, Lord, to witness to family and friends by thanking you before them, thanking you for who you are and what you've done. So we just ask you to open up that possibility that we can reach others with our love for you. Lord, we thank you for this opportunity. We thank you, Lord, even though we're going through this pandemic, that we as Christians know that you are in control. And by our faith and through our faith in you, we can have that peace that we don't understand. But we don't have to run with fear and be concerned with worry as long as we keep our eyes on you. The Father, we worship you today and believe in your word. We pray that you open up our hearts and minds, not only would we hear your word, but we would live out your word. You all the praise now in Jesus' name. Amen. Pastor Charles had a Thanksgiving message Sunday morning that really hit home with me. One of the points of his message was that we need to give thanks and support the Christians every day for what God's done in our body. But we can do that by getting a sacrifice of praise. One of the things he said we can do is declaration, in other words, declare what God has done for us, what God, how He's blessed our lives, how He's blessed our family, and so forth. So I thought about that, what I'm most thankful for is God's done so many things in my life, but really what I'm most thankful for is my salvation. So I thought, why not give a declaration of praise by giving my testimony? So I'm just going to give a short testimony on how God saved me, because in my opinion, it was miraculous. See, I was raised up in a good home, had a wonderful family, had a wonderful friend, had a wonderful Christian mom who took my brother and sister and I to church every Sunday, same right to church and Sunday school. Through my high school years, then I went to college. After college, I went into the Army for 3 years. And during that time, and for the years afterward, I didn't think about church, and I never really thought about God because I really hadn't given my life to Jesus in those early years. So I got out into the world and was living in carnality, really. And then I met this wonderful godly woman with Nancy, my wife now. And almost 31 years ago that we were married. And being around her changed my life. But within 4 or 5 weeks of being married, one day I heard this voice within me and it said, you need to go to church. Well, at the time, I stopped walking in the world beside him. Where did that come from? Of course, now, I know if the Holy Spirit brought me to Jesus. But at that time, I wasn't sure what was going on. But I knew once I had Necessary and all bitterness, wrath, anger, clamor, and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice, and be kind to one another, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as Christ forgave you. You got to settle for one another than those passages of Scripture. But you know, to be honest, we cannot love everyone on our own. We may try. Thank you. and his sight, and is the one who puts guilt on us because, if he can make us feel guilty, then we're going to be less effective in our walk for Christ. We're going to be less effective as far as witnessing to others and so forth. So, I know that doesn't bother us so much anymore, but we need to understand that it is Satan who puts guilt on us. And we need to remember, when we accepted Christ, that he not only, his shed blood not only covered our past sins, but they also covered our present sins, our future sins. So we must remember that. We just confess and repent and continue to live our life for Christ. You know, but the greatest emotion I have of all is joy. You know, when I think about being saved for what Jesus did for me on the cross of Calvary, he did for you, I have joy. I know that heaven is my home. I know that I've reunited with my friends and my family members and saints I've known throughout the years who were in heaven already. I know that I've seen Jesus face to face. It doesn't get any better than that. So, you know, if you're struggling in different areas of your life as far as being a Christian, just let the thought of the cross come into your mind, and I'll guarantee you that your walk will be for the Lord. I'd like to end with Hebrews 12, verses 1, 2, and 3. Therefore, we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which so easily ensnares us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us. Looking unto Jesus, that's the key, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and has sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. For consider him who endures such hostility from sinners against himself, lest you become weary and discouraged in your soul. You know, we can do a lot for Christ as we live for him, if we're trying to walk in his as he walked. To treat people as he treated people, we can make a difference in people's lives. But like I said, we go through struggles in this life, and it's easy to say, well, it's just not worth it, you know, to get up and come to church, to pray every day, or to read our Bibles. And we need to, just like Scripture says, not become weary and give up, but we need to keep on keeping on. Just as the Apostle Paul said in 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 25, that we are to run the race. You know, the race he's talking about is not a short sprint, a one-time sprint. He's talking about a marathon our whole life. So we just keep on keeping on, and we'll make a difference. And we'll find out that as we keep our eyes on Jesus, as we focus on the cross, that we'll want to be more obedient to Jesus. We'll want